गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अरोरा ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। लेट्स प्रोसीड विद द सेम लेसन, मैडम राइड्स द बस। इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास आई टॉट यू अबाउट बल्ली'ज ए स्ट्रॉन्ग डिसलाइक फॉर दैट एल्डरली वूमन। बल्ली गॉट इरिटेटेड बाय हर नॉनसेंस क्वेश्चंस एंड देन she told that elderly woman not to worry about her because she is strong enough to take care of herself. Now lesson means this part 3, actually it has 4 parts. So in part 3, till now we have seen that Valli is a very clever, intelligent and matured girl. At the same time, she is very bold and brave. She is confident. Sometimes she appears to be overconfident of herself. So we cannot expect such a great sense of maturity from such a young child like Valli. Now what happened that she made her plan to take a bus ride from her village to the nearest town. For this she had made painstaking efforts, some detailed plan. Actually, in order to enjoy a bus ride, she needed money. And it was very difficult for a child like Valli to save money. So she started saving money. She started saving every coin that came her way. So it was not an easy task. It was not an easy job for Valli to save money. So what did Valli do in order to save money? Actually, as I said that she was very intelligent girl and she was a good planner, quite scheming. Actually, she was a 8-year-old girl, such a small child. She had to control her desires, her childish desires, her childish urges. She sacrificed. So she resisted her desires to buy balloons, toys, candies, joyrides. I would say that she resisted her temptation of buying balloons, toys, joyrides, peppermints, means candies, toffees, like that. And by this way, she saved money. And now actually, she had to save 60 paise. Because 60 paise was the fare of both sides, both ways. Means there was 30 paise fare for one way, and now there was 60 paise fare of both wage, and thus she saved money 60 paise. And then she started her journey. She saw so many things I taught you earlier, and actually now the second thing was for her to slip out of her house when her mother was asleep, because she did not want to let her mother know about her bus journey, about her excursion, about her trip to the town. So she planned in such a way that during afternoon her mother must be sleeping, and that was the right time for her to slip out or sneak out of the house for a bus journey, for a bus trip, for a bus ride to nearest town. And she exactly did what she planned for. Now, what happened on her way to the town, on her way to the nearest town, she saw a very beautiful young cow. And actually, this scene was very funny. Something looked very funny for her. Because what happened, actually, the bus crossed many ways. It crossed many villages, many shops, and it crossed, many places. And on the way, at one place, actually, she was sitting at the window seat and she was looking out and enjoying the beautiful scenery, beautiful sights out of the bus, out of the window, outside the window. And suddenly she looked something funny. And what was funny? What was funny that she looked? So actually what happened? And she clapped her hands with glee. Glee means happiness. So she saw a young cow raising up her tail high in the air. And she was running in the middle of the road very fast, right in front of the bus. And now the bus driver had to save the cow. So the bus driver started sounding horn. The bus driver started honking. Honk means to sound the horn. Horn bajana. So the bus driver started honking, started sounding the horn in order to keep the cow stay away. But the cow might have got perplexed, the cow might have got panicked. And the cow started moving, running in the middle of the road in front of the bus. Isn't it? Sometimes this side, that side, like that. The cow started moving fast. So when Valli saw it, she clapped. She enjoyed a lot, isn't it? And the more he honked, the more frightened the cow became, isn't it? So it happened like that. So she laughed and she had the tears in her eyes, even though the conductors told Valli to save some tears for future also. Ma'am, madam, please save some tears for future also. Means in one way, these were the tears of her joy. But the conductor said like that, hey lady, haven't you laughed enough? Called the conductor, better save some for tomorrow. Means please don't laugh too much. It's enough for you. Like that, the conductor said. Now, actually, the bus came to the bus station and the passengers started getting off the bus. They're getting down from the bus. And Valli was still sitting in the bus. She was still sitting on her seat. The conductor was surprised and he came to Valli and told her to get down. But Valli did not want to get down. Valli told him that she doesn't want to get down. She has to go back on the same bus. And Valli said that here is 30 paise. I have 30 paise more because I have to go back. This is what Valli said. I have to go back on that same bus. So I am not going to get down. The conductor was surprised. Then the conductor offered her a cold drink. Ki please get down and there is a stall there. So, can I bring, please let me bring some cold drink for you? But Valli refused to accept this offer. It means the bus conductor offered her some cold drink. And the bus conductor insisted her on taking some cold drink. Free of cost, free of charge. Even though Valli said no. So this shows that Valli was full of self-respect and pride. She did not receive that offer, or she did actually she refused to accept the offer, which was free of cost, which was free of charge. This shows her self-respect, and this also showed that she was full of self-respect. She was full of self-esteem. She was and she did not want to receive anything free, or she did not want to receive any offer free of charge from a stranger, isn't it? So this happened like that, and now she had to come back from the same bus. She gave 30 paise once again to the driver and told him to give her a ticket, return ticket. Actually, the driver told her to get down and to have a look at the different sites, to have a look at the different shops, because when you go to a town, the town is having lots of sites, so many cloth center, so many places, so many shops, so many malls, isn't it? So many things worth seeing places in a town. But she refused to do so. She said that I felt like having a bus ride. That's all. And the conductor asked her, "You are traveling all alone?" She said, "Yes, I just wanted to have a bus ride. That's all. And please take this 30 paise. I'll remain here. I won't get down, and I'll go back home on the same bus. So please, this is enough." Now in chapter 4, the conductor actually gave her the ticket and asked her, inquired of her, ki whether her mother is looking for her. Then she said, "Nobody is looking for her." So once again, this is the return journey. The bus has started, and again there were the same sights, same wonderful sights. Valli wasn't bored in the slightest and greeted everything with the same excitement. Again, she was overjoyed, and she started watching the same sights as she was enjoying while going to the town, and while going back from the town, while going back her home, she enjoyed the same sights, the distant mountains, the green fields, everything in the same manner, in the same way, with lots of happiness, with lots of joy and excitement. Now, what happened? Now she came back. So, her destination had come. The bus has stopped and she got down there. She got off the bus. And then she turned to the conductor and said, "Well, sir, I hope to see you again." She was so frank and so bold and brave girl. Then the conductor also replied, "Okay, madam." The conductor replied, smiling, "Okay, madam, whenever you feel like a bus ride, come and join us. So we shall have a nice time with each other." And then she laughed and jumped down from the bus. And then away she went, running straight for home. Now she came back home. So when she entered her house, she found her mother awake. At that time, her mother had, she found that her mother had got up from sleep, and mother was awake. And at that time, when she came back home, when she returned home, she found that one of her aunts, she found that her mother was talking to one of her aunts. And this aunt was from South Street, some mohalla, some place. And actually, she says, Valli says, this aunt was really a chatterbox, very talkative. And one more thing I would like to say, while coming back home, means while on her way back home, Valli saw that a young cow was run over by, knocked down by some fast moving bus. This was the same beautiful cow when Valli saw and clapped her hands when she saw the cow running faster in front of the bus. This was the same cow, perhaps this was the same cow, but now the cow was dead. And it was the cow, the dead body of cow was looking very horrible and frightening. That is why this story is very sensitive. She felt very sad that this cow, just a while ago, this cow was alive, this cow was full of charms. She had life. And now she had lost her life. This cow had lost her life. This cow had lost the beauty of her life. This cow had lost the charm of her life. Now she is dead, and her dead body was lying beside the road. It might have been knocked down by or run over by some fast moving bus or any vehicle. Now there was no life. And the cow's dead body was smeared with blood. There were stains of blood on the dead body of the cow. So this tragic sight dampened her enthusiasm, and she lost all her enthusiasm. She lost all her happiness and joy. She felt very sad to see the dead body of the cow, and that this was the same cow which she saw a little while ago or sometime ago when she was coming from her village to the town. So there is also a mystery of death and life. Everything is good, everything looks very beautiful when you are alive and you can enjoy your life. But when death comes, the thing becomes ugly. When death comes, it snatches away every charm and every beauty of yours. So this is the mystery of life and death. She felt very sad. Now she came back and she found one of her aunts talking to her mother, and this aunt was from South district. Then when Valli came in, her aunt asked, "And where have you been?" So she spoke very casually, not expecting a reply. Valli just smiled, and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. Now mother was talking to that aunt, and mother was saying, "So many things in our life, in the world outside, and how can we possibly know about everything?" Means they were talking about the things that are happening in this world without their knowledge. So there are so many things that happen every day without our knowledge. There are lots of things that happen in our life. Her mother was talking about those things. There are so many things that happen in our life without our knowledge. We don't know what is happening or what has happened. So we cannot have the knowledge of, or we cannot have the idea of everything that happens in the world outside. And this is exactly what her mother was talking about. So the subject of conversation was about the things that are happening without their knowledge. So of course these things were happening without their knowledge. So how can we possibly know about everything? And even when we do know about something, we often can't understand it completely, can we? Oh yes, breathed Valli. "What?" asked her mother. "What's that you say?" Oh, said Valli, I was just agreeing with what you said about the things happening without Arno. Valli interrupted and Valli said, yes, you are right, Mama. Both of you are right. And Mama, you are right. My dear mom, my dear mother, my darling mother, you are absolutely right. There are so many things that happen without our knowledge. Valli agreed to it. And she gave a smile. Just a cheat of a girl, she said her aunt. And yet look how she pokes her nose into our conversation. Actually, her aunt got irritated as to why is she interfering in our conversation. See, this girl, she behaves as she were grown-up girl. She is just a chick, she is just an 8 years old girl, and she is talking like a mature girl. She is talking as if she has grown up. She were a grown-up girl. But Valli understood everything. Valli, why did Valli say like this? Valli said that nobody knew anything. Neither her aunt, neither her mother, nor her aunt knew that Valli had enjoyed a bus ride. Nobody knew that Valli went from this village to a town. She enjoyed this bus ride. She took this bus ride. So nobody had any knowledge about Valli's bus journey. So this was the thing which happened without their knowledge. And this was the subject about what they were talking. So Valli smiled to herself. She didn't want them to understand her smile. She kept it a secret. But then there wasn't much chance of that, was there? So actually, these are the things that we have come to know. And at last I would say that Valli was really very clever, very well-confident girl. And apart from being confident of herself, she was very bold and brave. She was a matured girl. She was beyond her age, though she was a very small child. But she was very intelligent and she was a good observer, isn't it? And actually, she sacrificed her urges, her desires to save money in order to enjoy the bus ride. So it is said that where there is a will, there is a way. And she was determined to fulfill her dream and to get a bus ride, to enjoy a bus ride was her dream, and she succeeded in fulfilling her dream just because of her determination and plans. Thank you very much, dear. And this way, this lesson comes to its end. So, dear students, actually, now we have two or three lessons. Let me tell you one thing. We have completed all the lessons except three. So, we have one poem, The Tale of Custard the Dragon. This poem is yet to be taught. Then we have one story, the Sermon at Banaras, number two chapters, and then we have the proposal. This is a play, isn't it? So now we have three chapters left, isn't it? So best of luck for your examination, and just revise your lessons properly. All the subjects are equally important. We should not make any kind of discrimination on the basis of the priority of the subject. You are a student, and from my point of view, or I am of the opinion that the students should regard each and every subject equally important. So go through the chapters, go through the exam portions, prepare well for your exams. That will be much better, and try to get better marks. Thank you very much, and please tell your parents to come tomorrow. to collect answer sets from your class teachers, from your respective class teachers. Don't be late for tomorrow. Thank you very much. That's all for today. Thank you very much, dear.